Wrestling Rampage here, back with another video.
That's right, we are Wrestling Rampage. We are back with another video. Don't forget to like us on Facebook, facebook.com/WrestlingRampage2. Follow us on Twitter at Wrestling Rampage. Hit that subscribe button because we're going to bring you guys more, right?
That's right.
More videos as the time goes on. Right now, gearing up for the Royal Rumble.
That's right.
Or as Hercules said,
Rumble Royal.
The Rumble Royal. What we got right now is we're going to be doing the top 10 Royal Rumble winners.
Yes.
Pretty much
our top 10.
Yes. Now we are going to be doing some more Royal Rumble videos as time goes on.
Yes.
You mind there, Phenomenal?
Huh?
Top 10 Royal Rumbles, right? We'll go ahead and we'll start off with number 10. Oh, and feel free to let us know if there's a one that we think that, that you guys think that we missed.
But this is our top 10.
Yes, it's all opinionated, so. And let us know in the comments below if you guys enjoyed the video. Give us a big thumbs up. With that being said, number 10 is the 2016 Royal Rumble. The winner was
Triple H.
He entered at number 30.
Of course.
And he, you know, the one thing about this, about the Royal Rumble
this,
2016.
Yeah, was AJ Styles.
Well, it was the debut of AJ Styles.
That's, you know, everyone, I think Triple H, I think Roman Reigns and Rusev were number one and two.
Yes.
And of course, you knew Rusev get eliminated by Roman, of course.
And it was funny that they put the camera on Roman for his face.
Yeah.
Like that when AJ Styles' music hit.
Yes. Because it was awesome.
So he's like, who the fuck's this guy?
Oh, he found out who he was, all right.
And actually, the one thing is, Roman Reigns' title was on the line. This was the second time that the WWE Championship, or WWF Championship, whatever you want to call it, was defended in the Royal Rumble match.
Which was pretty cool.
And when it came down to Triple H, and the last person in there was Dean Ambrose, I was still going for Dean Ambrose.
I was too, but Triple H.
God had to take
world title.
Of course, oh God, had to put that mighty sledgehammer down and say, "Thou shall be my 13th title reign."
Yep.
So, we're going to go with number 10, the 2016 Royal Rumble with Triple H. Number 9. Is the 2006 Royal Rumble. The winner was Rey Mysterio. Last person in was Randy Orton. The one thing that... And Rey Mysterio actually entered at number 2.
Yes.
And lasted until the end. Won the match. when he hurricanrana'd Randy Orton over the top rope. And got back in the ring. And the 2006...
I think this was the first time ever a number 2 entrant was ever won.
Yes, it was.
Royal Rumble match.
But also, this was the longest Royal Rumble match.
Don't he still hold the distinction of the longest...
Well, this was the longest Royal Rumble ever, because it was an hour and 2 minutes.
Yeah.
Now, 2016 was almost... It almost hit that time, but it didn't hit that time.
Yeah.
I think it was like an hour and a minute. But, what's your guys' thoughts on that anyway?
Well, I like Ray, but I think the only reason he won was because of Eddie's death.
Yeah, Eddie died, I believe, in November, I believe.
Yeah.
Of 2005.
So, I just think that's the only reason he won that.
And then you had January coming up with the Royal Rumble.
Yeah.
So
I kind of think he was just there because of Eddie's passing.
You know, to me, Ray was Ray to me was always mid card in my opinion.
He was. He did not have a good run as World Heavyweight Champion.
He did not. No, he did not.
You know, he didn't.
He didn't. I agree with you. The one thing that I did like about the 2006 World Rumble was they showed that even the smallest guy can win the World Rumble.
Yeah, and they had some pretty good people in that Royal Rumble, too.
Oh, yeah. What's your thoughts on Rey Mysterio?
The little guy wins it.
Finally.
finally, the little guy beats the big guys.
Mm-hmm. Well, speaking of big guys, we're going to go to number 8, which is the 2000 Royal Rumble, which was won by The Rock.
Is this when he was The Rock or Dwayne?
He wasn't Dwayne at this time.
Okay.
He was.
And he wasn't doing no Tooth Fairy movies.
No. Not yet.
He wasn't doing that game plan movie either, was he?
No.
You're
gonna keep listing me shitty Dwayne The Rock Johnson movies.
Basically, yeah.
Okay, you might as well just.
Yeah, because there's about 50 million of them.
This was the 2000 World Rumble, won by The Rock, and as you're talking about the big guy, the last person in was the Big Show.
Well, I don't think the Big Show was officially eliminated.
Well, The Rock entered at number 24.
What do you think about that Royal Rumble? There was a lot of great Attitude Era moments in that Royal Rumble. Come on. Too Cool Rikishi doing a dance in the Royal Rumble match.
Yes.
And, of course, Rikishi eliminates him after the dance. And, of course, you know, you see Grandmaster Scotty do a little. And, of course, he misses Grandmaster's shot there. And they all dance out leaving. Yeah, we knew Too Cool wasn't going to win it. You know. And my other favorite was Taka and Funaki. Okay, Takamichi, Nuku, Funaki, every time they get in that rumble, always got eliminated. And they always keep coming back. But my favorite was when Gangrel threw. It was either Gangrel or the Boss Man. Threw Taka over and his head hit the goddamn...
it went.
You remember that? That was probably the best rumble match. You know.
But... And it stands to reason with the controversy too, because they say Big Show that the Rock's feet actually hit the floor
before Big Show
before Big Show's did. Now, you know, you can't really see it on camera that well, but you know,
The Rock won it.
Became a big movie star, left the business, of course.
And I think that was the same year we got that shitty WrestleMania 2000 man. Triple H, The Rock, and Mick Foley, and Big Show.
Yes, we did.
Yeah. WrestleMania 2000 was not sitting on number 31.
Your thoughts on The Rock?
Well, they couldn't show a slow-mo or a replay of it like they do in the sports events, which I think that's what they should do for these rumbles right there. But they couldn't do it, so...
Well, they tried, but like... You couldn't see The Rock's feet.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was just like, Well.
But, you know, you got to figure, too, The Rock was going to win it anyway, so.
Well, speaking of feet hitting the floor, comes in at number 7. The 1995 Royal Rumble, won by the man, in my opinion, I know YouTube, the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels.
You know what the favorite about that match? Both British Bulldog and Shawn Michaels drew number 1 and 2.
Yeah.
I think Bulldog was number 2.
Yeah, Bulldog was number 2.
And they lasted till the better end. Like, it was down to them 2. Now, that's probably...
Now, the one thing about the 1995 World Rumble,
the talent was not that good.
Yeah, you had Jacob and Eli Blue. You had
the Bushwhackers.
One of the squad fucking people in that, squad member number 1 and squad member number 2?
Nah.
Or was that 96?
I think it was 96.
Well, anyway.
But,
shitty talent, 96 and 95 both. It doesn't really matter which way you go with it.
The only thing that was cool was seeing Dick Murdoch come out there. That was pretty cool. Little dirty dick.
But, last in was number 2. Bulldog and Shawn Michaels. Bulldog threw Shawn over the rope.
And the old one foot.
That's right. Which
the
is
Shawn Michaels rule.
The Shawn Michaels rule invented by Shawn Michaels. Both feet have to hit the floor.
Not just one.
And you go back and Shawn's grabbing the rope with the one foot hanging down.
That was pretty good.
It's pretty good. But
a lot of people said Bulldog got screwed there, but you know. But it clearly was 1 foot.
Well, you know,
that's the reason why that's number 7, because the talent was not that good.
Yeah. Let's just be honest. There was nobody besides Bulldog and Shawn that could win that Royal Rumble at that point. Because everybody else...
Bundy, give me a break.
Everybody else had big, you know, other matches in that card.
Yeah.
And you had Shawn Michaels, you had British Bulldog, and it's just like,
Like Luger.
Luger. And that's pretty much all you had as far as real good talent in that Royal Rumble.
Mm-hmm.
So it was no surprise that one of those guys was going to win.
Yeah.
So, but it was cool to see them last till the end.
Yeah.
And this was the first Royal Rumble where a person that entered number one lasted till the end and won. So, going on to number six was the 2007 Royal Rumble.
2007. They had a lot of good talent in that 2007 Rumble. My God.
This was the year before the whole shitty talent with the shit.
Look at that. They had all the ECW guys, all the SmackDown guys, and all the Raw guys.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it was down to the final four was Edge, Randy Orton, Undertaker, and Michaels. And, of course, Edge and Orton get eliminated. It's down to Undertaker and Michaels.
I wanted Shawn to win. I'm not going to lie.
I wasn't going to lie. I wanted Undertaker to win because I was like, he needs to win a Royal Rumble match, please.
And what happened? The Undertaker won. He
entered, and damn, it took forever. He's never won a Rumble match. That's probably the only thing he's never won.
He entered number 30.
Minus King of the Ring, but no one cares about that. He should have won 95, it might be. Him or Shawn. Because 95 give it to Mabel.
Undertaker entered at number 30. He was the last entrance. And also, that was the first Royal Rumble where the number 30...
Yeah, actually won.
Actually won.
I think it was Undertaker.
Yeah. And people are like, well, the best number is number 30, of course.
Look at the
It's Warbush. Not the case.
It's not occasionally. That's the way it goes.
As I remember, the Wardlord was number 30 and he didn't win.
Oh, God. Who is that one guy that I keep... Duke the Dumpster Dozy number 30.
Yeah, he won Duke number 30. And I didn't see Duke win that Rumble.
I think he walked
the trash man.
You know.
I think
sometimes number 30 don't plan out. I remember X-Pac was number 30 and he didn't win.
He didn't last.
And that was in the 2000 Rumble, by the way. He didn't win it.
Of course he didn't win. But... I enjoyed the 2007.
Oh, I love the Royal Rumble. That's like one of my favorite events.
Well, and number five is the 1996 Royal Rumble, where Shawn Michaels won it.
Yep.
Shawn again. A two-time Rumble winner.
That's right. And
I mean, it was 96 was another, Doug Gilbert.
That's who it was. They had the squad members, one and two. They had Doug Gilbert.
They had some Japanese dude.
Yes, and I was sitting there like...
They had Dory Funk.
They did have Dory Funk. Dory Funk Jr. was in there.
Yeah.
I'm like, what the fuck is this old fossil doing in there?
You know.
But, you know, I was like, man, they really have some shitty talent in 96 coming out of Royal Rumble.
Yeah.
I'm like, Doug Gilbert has zero chance.
When you seen Vader, he was all over him, Doug.
But, Shawn Michaels ends up winning, coming in at number 18. And,
eliminate Diesel.
Yeah, Diesel was the last person in. Super kick, there goes fucking Diesel.
Right out of the fucking combo was gonna win it.
Kyle was too busy fucking melting down Undertaker's fucking urn for that bullshit chain.
He was too busy.
But Shawn was on fire at that point.
I think I was for the main event at WrestleMania 12.
Yes, WrestleMania 12 against Brett for the WWF Championship, which was actually one of my favorite matches of all time. The 1 hour Ironman match.
Yes.
Number four, the 1998 Royal Rumble.
Oh, man.
Won by Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Yes, 98 was a great Royal Rumble.
They had a lot
of talent in that Rumble.
He entered number 24, and the last person that was in the ring was Vader.
Yep.
He eliminated Vader. And the one thing that
No, he eliminated The Rock.
The Rock, yeah. But...
It was down to The Rock and Austin.
But the one thing that struck me with this match was this is the first World Rumble where Mick Foley entered three times.
He tried to win that Rumble three times.
Mankind.
He went in there as Cactus Jack first.
Yes.
Then he went in as Mankind, and then here he comes as
Dude Love.
And all three got eliminated.
I was sitting there he took three spots in the Rumble.
Yeah. But you see, that's the thing, though. Mick Foley made history by being in it three times. He made history.
He tried three times to win that motherfucker.
Couldn't get it. Stone Cold won. Nope.
Three different characters.
Rock.
But, yeah, so...
I remember even the Honky Tonk Man was in that motherfucker. I was like, God damn.
He didn't last long.
No, he didn't.
Number three. Perhaps one of my favorite War Rumbles, no doubt, was the 2002
War Rumble. Oh, yes. That Royal Rumble.
I mean, not only the War Rumble match, but...
The entire pay-per-view was good.
Was entirely good.
And I was waiting. I was with you waiting.
Yes.
Mr. Perfect. I was like, I can't wait to see Mr. Perfect in the fucking Royal Rumble, right?
Yes.
And fucking...
He was a surprise entrance, yeah, came out.
Yeah, I think the big ovation. Godfather, Val Venus, Goldust, and Mr. Perfect.
Yes.
And fuck, I was like, when the hell is Mr. Perfect going to get in this bitch?
Mr. Perfect comes out, big ovation. I'm sitting there like, fuck.
At first, I was scared because he was in there with Austin and Triple H. I was like, oh, God, don't eliminate him, please. You know? And then Mr. Perfect made a fucking good showing.
It was down to Triple H, Kurt Angle, and Mr. Perfect. And I'm like, come on, Kurt, man, come on. And there goes, gets thrown
there
out.
There goes Mr. Perfect.
and then Triple H eliminates Kurt.
Yep.
And then you see Triple H.
Triple H is the winner of the Rumble. That was because, a good Rumble.
Because, of course, they had to play the before his return, Oh Beautiful Day by U2.
That was a good Rumble, though.
Triple H comes back from the quad injury that he came back from. And Triple H entered number 22 in that Rumble.
Yes.
And there was also one other thing about that Rumble that was really just odd completely, was when Maven eliminated The Undertaker.
Yes.
The rookie Maven drop kicks The Undertaker.
But then he got his ass beat.
Oh, yeah.
I remember when Sky Too Hot came out, fucking Undertaker hits him. He's like, I ain't in the mood to dance.
Fucking throws.
No dancing, Scotty!
Throws a Maven into the popcorn machine, grabs some, eats some, and then walks away.
Spits the popcorn kernel.
But 2002, no doubt, was one of my favorite years when it comes to WWE. Perhaps Pops' favorite War Rumble. And especially this Remember the Rumble that they keep talking about. Of course, they don't want to remember the 2004 War Rumble, which equals number two for us.
Yep.
Which the winner, it entered at number one. This is the second person in history, and they never announce the second person. They always announce Shawn, but they always stiff the second one.
Yeah.
And that is...
That's Chris Benoit, fucker.
Chris Benoit entered number one, stayed in the Rumble.
Yep.
Won the War Rumble.
Yes, he did.
Last eliminating the Big Show. Everybody's like, oh, Big Show's going to win this, you know. You know, Benoit short compared to Big Show. And Chris had the head right there. Got
him. Dumps him over.
Wins it. Goes on to WrestleMania 20. Wins the World Heavyweight Championship. Yep. Makes history. And then makes history again in 2007.
Yep.
To the ultimate demise.
Yeah.
But,
they got a lot of good talent in that Royal Rumble.
One of my favorites was Ernest the Cat Miller coming out.
Here he comes with, oh my God. He dances during the Rumble. And I can't remember who. Oh, Randy Orton.
Randy Orton.
Like, get the fuck out of here. And, we don't need you.
And Mo Green was with him.
Yeah, he gets eliminated by Benoit.
And Benoit grabs Mo Green, grabs his hair falls off, and then throws him over there.
Oh, yeah.
But 2004 was definitely a good War Rumble.
Oh, yeah.
Coming in at number one in the last War Rumble for the top 10 War Rumble winners was the 1992 War Rumble.
Oh, yeah.
Won by, woo, the Nature Boy Ric Flair, who entered at number three.
Number three.
I remember that. You hear the little bell thing go off, and then here comes Ric Flair with Mr. Perfect, and you hear Bobby.
It's not fair to Flair.
It's not fair to Flair.
Yeah.
You know, fucking grill him on and say, sit down.
Sit down. What's wrong? You're gonna lose your meal ticket.
He was standing up there watching that right there, and goes, "Don't jump! Don't jump!"
This was the first. Time the WWF Championship was on the line in the War Rumble.
You know, they had a lot of good people in that Rumble, my God.
except for the last person that was in there with.
Oh, well, we knew the Warlord won one, man. Give me for break. You think Skinner? Skinner's going to win the Royal Rumble? What the fuck?
Sid Justice?
Come on, Virgil. Give me a break. There's some people in that Rumble I knew weren't going to win that.
I was going with Skinner.
How the hell would you go with Skinner?
I'd go with the Skinner over Maven.
You know, but it was down to Sid
Justice
and Ric Flair. And Hogan helped.
Yeah, Hogan shook yeah. Sid's hand, grabbed him over the rope, and Flair throws him over.
Yeah, looking great.
Yeah,
it was. And then the classic promo in the bag with Mean Gene. Hey, put that cigarette out!
I want to know who was smoking that cigarette.
With a tear in my eye. This is the greatest moment in my life.
I love
and that's Ric Flair.
Right I there. Love that 92 Rumble.
Yes.
I did. That's why that is probably the best Royal Rumble of all time, in my opinion.
And that's why it's number one.
That's why it's number one.
A man is unanimous decision to make that number one. That was the top 10 WWE War Rumble winners of all time.
In our opinion.
That's right. Make sure you guys like us on Facebook. Facebook.com/WrestlingRampage2. Follow us on Twitter @WrestleRampage. We're hoping to gear this up for War Rumble coming up here in about a week or so. And, you know, don't forget to watch it on the WWE Network.
For only $9.99.
Only $9.99.
We're free $9.99 for new subscribers.
That's right. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel because we're going to bring you guys more and more content as the time goes on. Tommy, why don't you give us a little Larry, a living legend Larry Sabisco.
All right. Everyone, have a good day.